Hey, welcome to AntLab Games, where our board game playthroughs are always unpaid and ad-free.
I'm your host, Francis.
And I'm Anthony.
And today we're going to be taking you through Curious Cargo. So this is a tile placement game designed by Ryan Courtney, published by Capstone Games. It is for two and only two players.
Just how we like it.
And plays in 30 to 60 minutes.
All right, so join us at the table and we'll show you how it plays. All right, welcome. Welcome to the factories.
Welcome to our factories.
That make, we make...
We like don't even know what we're making, I think, we're not sure.
Blue potion bottles and green battery. Green car batteries, they look like.
They're like, you guys got to get rid of this stuff.
Yeah, so. Well, we're producing it and shipping it.
Right.
So what is Curious Cargo? Two-player tile placement has the look of Pipeline.
But nothing. None of the mechanics.
That's where it ends. That's where it all ends. So we are playing. There's multiple modes in this game. Mm-hmm. There's multiple different layouts, so you can actually like player boards, if you will. And there's also a sort of a more challenging, I would call it the expert version of this, where they add a third color, and that'll make sense more when we start to talk about the game. But we're not playing that one either. So we're playing the bare bones, plain vanilla copy version of Curious Cargo. So we are, according to the rule book, we're actually friends who got invested in these companies that create some kind of mysterious cargo.
That we like don't even know what it is.
Yeah,
it's
mysterious
like we kind of like stumbled upon this cargo and somebody was like, go build your factory.
And I was like, that'd be a great idea to invest in this factory that has these weird
widgets,
if you want to call them. And then we're going to ship them out, right? So the whole game is about shipping this cargo, well, creating a production line.
Yeah.
To ship the cargo onto a truck and then receive the cargo from the other person's factory. Mm-hmm. Into your factory, which...
And try to do it better than your friend.
Than your friend, yeah. So, enough of that. Take a look at the board. We'll go through really quick how this is going to roll, and then we'll hop right to it. So, we have it set up a little bit differently than how you would normally set it up if you were home.
Correct.
Because you would normally be sitting across from each other. Mm-hmm. So, this is my board. That board is Francis's. Normally, you'd be sitting on opposite ends of the table, because it helps you sort of visualize what's actually happening with the trucks. But we have our factories and our cargo, right? So we've got these six blue potions and these six red batteries that we're going to be looking to ship. Now, this is my factory. Mm-hmm. This side of my factory is shipping. This side of my factory is receiving. So I can build pipes out of my machines. They're just machines, right?
Mm-hmm. La machine.
La machine. They do just about anything. When it comes to building red and blue items. So depending on the color pipe I build out of these machines, I can connect them to any one of these shipping bays.
Correct.
Right? And then it will be ready to ship that particular item from my warehouse onto a potential truck that's been pulled up to load said cargo. Mm-hmm. So that's one thing you can do. So you're building pipes, red or blue pipes, to these bays to load trucks. Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, Frances is going to be doing the same thing, but she's going to be trying to get them over on this side because that's her shipping.
Yeah.
Her trucks are eventually going to be driving up past my factory, and they can't go past my factory without stopping and thinking about dropping something off if they happen to be carrying her red or blue goods. And if I just so happen to have a pipe from one of my machines.
It's just so weird because we're making the same stuff.
I know, but I want your stuff and you want my stuff before it goes out to the market.
Right.
Maybe I'm buying your stuff at cost and then reselling it on Etsy
or eBay or the
Facebook Marketplace, and I'm actually jacking the prices up because I'm keeping the demand high because the supply is low, right? So in any case, she's going to be moving her goods. I'm going to be trying to soak them up, but I have to have a pipe coming into any one of my machines from my receiving that matches the bay in her truck to the bay in my warehouse for me to take that. So if I can get that, I can put that over here on my player board. I have slots for four blue and four red, right?
As
so there's a whole that. So that's really the core of this game.
Yeah, the core of the game is really ship this stuff,
yep.
Get points, finish the game, and receive this stuff get a star and hopefully win.
Finish the game, right? So how does the game work, right? So you've got two phases. We're going to have a construction phase, mm-hmm. where we're going to get three actions to draft and place tiles on our boards. And then we're going to have a shipping phase. We're going to be able to play these shipping cards.
Like a trucking
phase. Trucking cards, yeah, truck phase. So the truck phase, we're going to play truck cards that will allow us to get trucks and put them in either my, this is where it gets interesting. I could mm-hmm. put the truck either in my shipping lane or
send a shipping truck to
her shipping lane. And then basically force her factory to load that truck if I really want to scoop up some of those goods, right? From the receiving perspective. Why? Because if you look at the player boards, there is a star on this fourth item. So mm-hmm. if I were to fill up four blue or four red, I earn a star. Mm-hmm. End game happens when one player earns a star.
Right.
Any star. So there's two ways to earn stars there. This tracks how many links you have from machines to bays. Mm-hmm. Every time you create a link, you'll go up one. As long as you have cumulatively
right.
created links.
Yeah, and the reason that we say that is because you'll see as we start playing tiles, we won't go over all the tile placement rules right now, mm-hmm. But we may actually like break links, which you would assume might send us back on the track, but that's not how that works.
Right. So once you establish one, two, mm-hmm. three links, for example, you'll always be credited those three links on that board.
Yeah.
If you ever reach 10, you'll earn a star. End game. Game ends if the truck deck runs out of cards, mm-hmm. the bag of tiles is empty.
Yeah.
Or you earn any one of these stars, or if we ship 9 cargo.
Correct.
So we have 12 cargo, so you need to ship most of it. So any of that happens, game over.
Right.
Person with the most stars, which will probably be the one who finished it, wins. Mm-hmm. If there's a tie, you both happen to get a star that round, it's going to go to
points,
and you'll get points depending on what you've achieved during the game.
Right.
And that's pretty much it. So we're just going to go doing our construction phase, which can be done simultaneously mm-hmm. because there's really no need for turn order.
Right.
But you are player one because your forklift is on top.
Nice.
So during the truck phase, you'll be able to do that first because that's where it matters because timing of the trucks is very important.
Exactly. And we'll explain why when we start bringing those out.
Yep, so I think we can explain the construction and trucking tokens later.
Yeah.
These
splitters.
Yeah, the splitter tokens later, as well as these five scaffolding tokens,
right.
Which just help you build. And we'll go through some of the more finer rules as we start playing, because I'm going to get right into the game.
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
Are you gonna build some widgets?
I'm ready. Okay. Just so you know, we all have three cards at the start of the game. We were dealt from the truck deck. And we'll tell you how these work once we get to the truck phase, because there's nothing you can really do with them right now.
Right. So in this phase, we have basically two things that we can do, mm-hmm. and we can do a total of three actions of those two things.
Correct.
So we can pull tiles out of this bag. Mm-hmm. We can place out on the board. So I'm actually going to start by just drawing two tiles
mm-hmm. and seeing if I want to place. All right, so I will do the same. This first round's pretty simple. We don't have any tiles to draw from.
And you can see that the tiles are actually double-sided if you're playing with the other.
Yeah, ignore the dark side for this game because we don't have the purple factory goods in here.
All right, so I pulled these two.
So these stay. So the way this works is, as Francis said, you're going to have three actions you can take. So I've taken two of those actions by drawing two tiles from the bag. If I were to place a tile now, that's my third action. Or I could take another tile from the bag, and that would be my third action. So what I have to decide now is, do I want to actually place one of these, or do I want to, you know, draw more from the bag?
Mm-hmm.
And I think I may place one of these.
I am in two as well.
So as you play the game, anything you draw from the bag during this round is in your hand. Like, think of it as cards in your hand.
Mm-hmm.
And you get to play them and think about it. But at the end of this phase, you're going to have to store them in your storage. And once they're in storage, you only have access on subsequent turns to the top tile. So you can use both sides, but eventually you'll have to cover up something.
Yeah.
And you can't get back down to that unless you play the one above it. So
right.
Let me think about what's going on
top
here.
Top tiles on the top shelf.
Okay, so I'm going to place that there.
Okay.
Maybe in the hopes that that is a good move. So drew a tile. No, drew two. Placed mm-hmm. one. I've got this one. I'm going to have to store it.
Yep.
Because that's the end of the phase. So that's where you kind of do that simultaneously. Pretty quick and simple. Now it's trucking. So in trucking phase, you get to go first.
Yes.
You get to play three. The three different ways here. So you have three different things you can do. The first thing is you can play a card to play a truck. And now each card has a truck that would correspond to a specific truck in one of those piles, and you just have to dig through to find it. And that particular truck is going to cost one or two action points. You're allowed to spend up to two action points worth of cards for this particular action. So if I have two trucks that are worth one each, I can play both cards, one at a time.
To get trucks.
To get two 1 action point trucks, right. And that'll spend that. If I have two action point truck, I only get to play that one. That's if I'm going to take the truck action where I'm going to play a truck. The second part is
I can illustrate right now.
Yeah, go ahead. Show me.
Yeah. So instead of doing trucks, because I don't obviously have any infrastructure, it'd be silly to bring in some trucks at this point. Unless I wanted them to bring it on your side.
Well, the
and
trick
get them
is
ready to move over.
And then the trick is though, like when you bring a truck in, it's not like going to move
it
on its
move.
Own.
Yeah, exactly. You have to like push it. So as trucks come in, you're actually going to push them down as new trucks come through. So none of that is smart right now. So I am actually just going to play this. This card for the machine parts. So at the bottom of these cards, there's actually a machine parts purchase order. So this allows me to get three of those tiles.
Yeah, so throw it up here so they can see that one.
Out of the bag.
Yeah, play, if you play, you get to do this for one card to play it for the parts, and you get to draw three tiles with this particular card. And it's going to get discarded from the game.
And so that's the same way. I'll look at them and then I'll store them.
Yeah, you're gonna have to store them all. You can't place any of them.
Right.
But it's a good way to build up sort of your supply of pipes.
Sure.
I'll bring a truck in. Because why not? I'm gonna bring in this monster truck. Monster truck. Yeah, maybe not a monster truck. Maybe I'll bring in this little baby truck. I'll bring in this guy. This guy's kind of generic. So this is a size 5 truck. Because he's got, they count the head. So here's, I got to go in this pile of these size 5 guys. And I'm looking for one that's exactly the truck I'm looking for. And that's this one here. Now I can bring this into her shop if I want to, or I can bring it into mine. So he comes in and he fills up as far as he can go. So right now, as you can see, bays 1, 2, and 3 are not in the factory. So you can't load anything from there. But I can connect pipes into bays 4 through 9. So with this truck in a current position, I can only load that particular spot adjacent to bay 4. So if I were to connect to bay 4, like if I had a pipe connected here into bay 4, I would load, say this is blue, I would load a blue item into this particular truck. That truck's not gonna move until I play another truck card in a subsequent turn to push that truck down the line, right? So that's how the trucking works. So that's my 2 action point card, and that's done.
Okay.
So that's my trucking phase.
I'm thinking about things.
Okay. Another, one last thing you can do on the trucking turn action is you can discard 2 tiles from storage, whether they be 2 from one pile or 1 from each, to get a truck card.
Right.
That's your third option.
I'm just planning.
Planning ahead?
Planning ahead. All right.
All right, so we are done with the trucking phase.
Yes.
And now we move on to back to the construction phase.
Yeah. All right.
So, yeah, we do that simultaneously. Cool.
All right, so I'm going to...
You know what you're doing?
Yeah, I'm just going to play... So I'm going to... For 2 actions, I'm going to play these out. So I'll play this here. And then I'm going to play this like that.
All right.
So, I have made a connection to a pipe.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So, I actually can move up one.
So, I can do that, and I just made a connection as well. So, I move up one as well. So, I go on top. Now, I'm actually player one.
Right.
This connection actually connected a truck. Boom. So, that blue pipe.
Oh, nice.
Loads a blue good.
Look at you.
Automatic.
All right.
Boom. So that was my first action. I'm just going to draw 2 tiles.
Wait a minute. I need to draw a tile as well.
Okay. It doesn't matter.
Because I placed 2 and I
draw. Order doesn't matter in this phase.
I know.
So there you go.
Look, that guy's got a light bulb on his head.
Well, you're free. I'll explain the scaffolding. So scaffolding is if, for example, I wanted to. Now, keep in mind, which is pretty interesting, is you can place tiles on top of tiles.
Yes, you can.
So that's how you can break links. But it's how you can also create additional links. But mm-hmm. if, for example, I wanted to place this tile like that, mm-hmm. I'd have to put that scaffold there to support this. Otherwise, this thing would be hanging on the floor.
Right.
And that's not legal. So that's the only reason you would need those scaffoldings. You only have five, so you got to use them wisely. But this follows, as far as placement, because we really didn't talk about it, but it follows the standard placement rules. Tiles can't go off the board. Mm-hmm. They can't, like I said, they can't hang off of something. You can't cover up right. one of your machines. It's common sense.
Right.
So yeah. they have to just fit in. And they're all two squares long. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Whether or not you want to connect a red and a blue, you can. It's just not legal. And you won't be able to...
You're not going to ship anything.
Not going to ship anything. Yeah. It's just a waste right. of a placement. But you can do it. Like, yeah. anything goes.
Cool.
And you can stack on top, like I said. So that's the end of that. Now we're in the trucking phase. So what do I want to do? I don't know.
I'll mention at any time, too, you can switch out two of your tiles, your pipe tiles, to get another truck card.
Yeah, I mentioned that earlier.
Oh, you did?
Yes,
I was not paying attention.
Another thing to note, this little...
I was scheming.
This box in my truck, a lot of boxes in some of these trucks, they will prohibit anything from being loaded. They're already loaded. So it's coming from another, like, it's coming from, like, a ShopRite, and it's already got food in it, like a pallet of food, so I can't load anything in there,
mm-hmm.
or a Walmart. So I'm just thinking how many I want to get this truck moved up to be viable.
Uh-huh.
So I'm gonna get a four. One, two, three. Ah, so I need one of those guys.
One of these.
So what I think I'll do...
See, I don't like that.
Yeah, this isn't great. I like to push that up. The thing is, that these trucks have rewards on the cab,
mm-hmm.
which you only get it if you fill the truck.
I know.
Some of the rules with loading, I'll go over there as well. You can't... Like, if this truck moves up, every pipe will simultaneously load it, as long as there's not something blocking it, like
mm-hmm.
another good already in the truck. And you can't load two of the same color good adjacent to each other in
right.
the truck. So I couldn't load two blues, so I'd have to go blue. Here
you
I could put
pick.
Blue.
Right.
Yeah, you could pick which ones go in there if that becomes the case, but if all you have is a blue to go, you can't load a blue. Blah, blah, blah. So I think, actually, I'm going to play another truck. So I'm going to need... this pile.
Okay.
And I'm going to pull this guy.
Okay.
And what he's going to do is he's going to push this truck up so that he can get into position. But now that opens up some more bays. Salt Bay.
Salt Bay. So weird. All right. I guess I will just play this size 6 truck. Which stinks because this is this guy, but at least he's got a bunch of cargo on him, you know? So once he comes into my little depot, he can just...
You can fill him up pretty quickly.
Fill up quick.
You can fill his bucket.
Done.
All right, so that guy is done. So that's the end of the truck phase.
Yeah.
Back to the...
Tile
place. Well, the construction phase. So go ahead.
Well, actually, your player one.
It doesn't matter.
Well,
this is the simultaneous.
That's what you think.
Well.
Depends. What if you drew the perfect tile? What if I drew your perfect tile right now?
What if you drew the perfect tile?
Yeah. Let's see. Actually. Yikes. The thing that gets me in this game every time is I'm gonna draw one and then I'm gonna work on placing stuff. What gets me in this game is that you can't flip the tiles to get the right... Like, you would think you'd be able to flip this and, like, turn it to the way you need it.
Mm-hmm.
And I always get backwards with, like, what direction... Like, I need this to attach that way. Do you know what I mean? Do you know what I'm saying?
I hear you. All right, so that's two actions, and I get to draw one more tile for my third action. Eek. These are not the tiles I was looking for.
Yikes.
I'll tell you that.
I guess I'll do that. Ugh. I'm not thrilled about this, really. So that's placement. I can go one. Two.
Interesting.
So I did. I pulled one. I placed one. Mm-hmm. And I have one more action.
So you can place one or you can draw another one.
What were you going to say?
No, that's it.
I'm not, like, super happy about this. See, like, I would like to put that pipe here. I need, like, the backwards version of that pipe that I already have if I do this. You know what I mean? Ugh. All right. I'm just going to put this here for my last.
Okay. And for my... my trucking action, I'm going to just discard two of these tiles to draw a trucking card.
All right.
And your turn.
Trucks?
I like trucks.
I like trucks. okay, I guess I'll do this. I'll get just a size 2 truck.
That's a baby truck.
It's a Berber. He's like...
It's like a box truck.
It's like a little box truck, like a little U-Haul. Oh, no, I moved him past there.
Oh, you just...
No! Yeah. Oh, there's no truck that can
take
help
that back.
Me. No, there's literally no truck that I can bring out. That was dumb.
Oh.
Dumb.
Wait a minute. Stop.
What?
Go back. Take the truck off.
Yes.
You when you loaded this truck, oh yeah,
no,
you need
see
to go.
How it's
oh
off?
Yeah, you have you
see
can't.
What I mean?
Yeah, there's no,
like,
truck that'll work for that.
I mean, all I can do is try to build
get him up here. Yeah, that's
stuff.
Your only
that's
bet.
So
except
stupid.
When I send my next truck onto your side.
Yeah, you know what? Then I'm just gonna grab more parts.
Okay,
I'm
so
using
you
him
want,
for parts.
You use him for three parts then. Okay.
My conceptual, like, what is that called?
My spatial
awareness.
Awareness.
Baby brain is a thing.
Yeah.
And I'm coming back.
Okay.
But my spatial awareness is, like, not there at this point.
This is where
time.
I step in.
This is exactly where
and
I
take the W.
You do.
When I can.
When you can, exactly.
Take what I can
when
I can.
You have a little bit of time left, I think.
Well, that's good.
Okay.
So you got your three tiles.
I got my tiles.
You just
got
to store them.
I'm just, like, not happy about it.
Fine. Yeah, so we're on to the construction phase now.
Okay.
So I think I want to start by putting a tile down for
yeah,
one.
Yeah, like, legally I have to, like, store these first.
I will draw one. Yes, you do. Draw one tile for my second action.
Wow, that's like, look at this little pipeline I made on my storage bin.
Not usable. Draw one tile for my third action. Okay, that's
one. Two. Oh, can't do it.
Mm-mm.
Ah. See, I want to be able to flip that over. I can't.
Darren lies the challenge here.
Oh, I know. Yeah, because I'm trying to get that thing that you're putting out here.
Oh, you want to receive.
Well, I would like to be able to.
The goods.
Receive, yes, the goods. It would be nice. I'll just put that out there.
Those are your three actions?
Yeah, those are my three actions.
All right. All right. Trucking we go.
Okay. All right.
You're first.
I'm first, and I have no truck cards. So, do I want to trade in these tiles?
Tiles or trucks?
Yeah, tiles or trucks. I'm going to have to. It's not like I super need them anyway. Yeah, that guy's up. Bum as well. So I'll trade these two in for one and hope it's something I can use.
You can't use it now. So I will trade this guy in for three tokens. Well, your action was to take the card. Mm-hmm. That's the whole action. So I'm gonna get three tiles. Ooh, yeah, I kinda like these. Yeah, I like these. We're gonna go one, two, three. That's it.
So that's not an anytime thing.
What, two for a card?
Yeah.
Just in the trucking phase.
Yeah, okay. I've never been so hard up.
Yeah, well, you can draw three tiles now.
I'm gonna have to. Well, I'll draw one at a time.
So I'm gonna go ahead and connect some stuff here.
Ew. I like this guy. Well, theoretically, I guess I could do like that.
Boom, so that's a connection. And that immediately loads. Batteries.
One.
And that gives me a truck token.
That's good.
Which can be traded in during the trucking phase.
Two.
Which is nice. Give me some extra actions.
Yeah, getting all these like straight blue pipes. All right, I'm just gonna lay this one here for my, not exactly how I wanted to connect that, but whatever.
That was one action.
I'm sorry, what?
I said I was just thinking that was one action for me.
Okay.
Just one action. Two? And three.
Nice.
That's a good.
Those are good ones, those elbows to have in that spot.
Those are my three. All right, that's trucking. Good.
Okay. Well, now I don't even want to do this because I need more pieces.
Yeah. Yikes.
Yeah.
Okay, so we just noticed something we have to swap out. Yeah, yeah, so when you grab, as I've been doing, and you notice, when you play your truck card and you grab a truck, you have to find the truck on your card. That's not even the truck on your card. Let's look at that again. This is the truck. I'm sorry.
It's too small. Okay.
So you dig through the pile, and we'll look for a truck with the, oh.
Sorry.
Yeah, if you dig through the pile, you'll find the one with the truck on top and the cab. There you go. That's the one.
Okay.
Easiest way to find them is by the bonus.
Right.
It is. It's typed pretty small. Do you remember where that was?
Yeah, it was right here.
Okay.
My connections. There we go. Okay.
All right.
Yeah, because I was like, that wasn't.
Fortunately, you didn't load anything.
I know, because
actually, that does change things now. Because had you loaded that truck initially, you would have loaded a blue.
Correct. Okay. There we go.
Mm-hmm.
And you'd still be sitting there.
Still be sitting there, yeah. But that could change what I do with him now.
Okay. Well, I'm first, so.
Oh, that's fine.
I don't want to, like, not use this guy, but I have plans. All right, I'm going to play this size 6 truck, this other one that I had actually put up there by accident.
So you're going to play another one?
I'm going to play this one, and I'm going to play it to your shipping area here and push all these guys down. And he's basically just going to slide all the way in.
Yeah, so go ahead.
It just tells you how many spots he's going
to take. Yeah, he goes to, as far as he, to fit in your board, he pushes everybody. Anybody hanging off your board immediately goes to the next board.
Yes. That's it.
So that's where he'll stop. Okay. Yep. And, that's actually good for me. All right, so I'm actually not going to take an action. Okay, so the just to clarify loading and how it works. Now, we were doing a little bit early on, but formally, in the trucking phase, in the beginning of the trucking phase, anything lined up would load.
Right.
And every time you play a trucking card, you would load. If it's available. So your truck being moved actually loads triggers a load, and I get that bonus because I filled the truck. So I get to draw a tile.
Yeah.
Which is good. I'm good with that. Another thing with the trucking phase, you don't have to take any actions if you don't want to. And I'm not sure if I want to load. I might actually play a truck now. Okay. I'm going to play this size 6 truck and push.
Are you kidding?
All these trucks out of my face.
What?
I want them out of my face.
But I wanted to line those up perfectly.
Oh, well. So look, this is what's going to happen. This guy's going to push up and anybody, and that's where it stops. This guy's gone.
Well, that's not great
for
me. I shouldn't have done that.
And then this guy is actually going to load here, and oh, he can't load there. Dang it. I need to move him up. Now he's done. All right, so now we're on to construction phase.
Great.
That was a lot of trucking action.
That wasn't fun.
Well, it was good trucking activity. I'm clearing out my warehouse. I do need to get some stuff loaded, though.
I shouldn't have done that. All right. Hold one for one.
I do need to get some. Okay, that'll work. That's one. Draw one.
Ugh, that's like all I can do. Two. Oh, that doesn't even go anywhere. Ugh. Oh, there we go, like that.
All right, so I've got a
two.
A third. Oh, I forgot. You get one of these.
Three.
Because you were the first to hit the three,
oh,
so
yeah,
you get that bonus, and the second person gets two of them, which is nice.
That doesn't make any sense.
It's a catch-up mechanic.
Well, you don't need any catch-up mechanics in this game.
Well, you're racing ahead of me.
I'm racing to finish this thing. All right, there. I connected a pipe,
oh,
so I get a card.
You get to draw a card. That's actually
good,
really good.
Now I can participate in the trucking phase.
That's really good. I'm glad you did that.
Oh, my goodness. Okay.
Also good to note, these construction tokens, you can play during the construction phase. And they give you two more actions.
Mm-hmm.
And you could trade two of these in for a trucking token. And then you could trade two trucking tokens in for one of these guys. Which are very nice. I like them.
That was all my actions. Are you done with your tiles?
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah, I drew one and placed two.
All right, so I'm going to... I'm not thrilled with this.
I think I don't want to play one of my tokens.
What?
Actually, because I could do it during this phase. Because it gives me two actions.
Mm-hmm.
Or it allows me to place a splitter, but I don't have one. So I'm going to play one, and I'm going to collect two more of these tiles. Well, I can collect one and place one if I want to.
Okay. What I'm going to do is... Are you going to do that now?
Mm-mm. Well, you can still play... Oh, you're doing the trucking?
Oh, yeah. I don't want to confuse the people.
You need to wait a second.
Okay.
You do need to wait your turn. Yes. Wait your turn, please.
You know I like to cheat, so...
You do. You really do, though. Mm.
I can't believe you put that giant truck and knocked out all the stuff I wanted to bring in.
That was a clutch.
I had so much receiving I wanted to do.
That was a clutch play. That's what has to happen sometimes. I think this guy is going to go here. All right, so that's one. Drew a tile, placed a tile. That's my two actions. Now it's your turn. Trucking.
I don't want to play this card on that side. Yeah, that's not what I want to do. All right, I'm just going to use this for parts.
Oh, three parts,
one, huh? Two,
three. Yeah. Three
parts. Right.
Yeah, they can't see down here.
What? Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's got to be up
sorry,
here.
Sorry, people of YouTube.
Three parts. For my trucking, do I want to trade these in? Yeah, I'm going to trade these two in for a card. That'll be my trucking turn. Oh, that'll work.
Your trucking turn.
That's my trucking turn. You take your trucking turn.
I'm trying to think how I want to store these based on how I want to use them. I keep getting like blue pipes. Gosh, I don't even like any of these.
Is that card done over there?
Yeah, it's... This is my trash pile.
Oh, you get your own discard over there? Okay.
I got my own discard. Don't you worry.
All right, so.
All right, there we go.
Heading into construction.
All right.
I'll start by grabbing a tile. Go ahead. For one. Two and three. Whoa.
I will place that for one.
I'll play this for two more actions. Draw one. That'd be a pretty cool move, actually. Instead of, I could actually place that. Man, that would be bad. That would be bad. I'll just draw another tile. Oh, these are terrible.
You're taking all the red ones. I'm just gonna end up with all the blues.
Hmm.
All right, one, two. Can I use it? Like nothing going on. I guess I'll do, maybe I'll do like this for three. No, that pipe doesn't go anywhere. Why would I do that? This is the worst warehouse ever. Like in the history of warehouses. Yikes. Oh, it's so bad. Just do that. Hope for the best.
All right, trucking.
All right.
What are you going to do?
I have no cards.
I don't really want to bring... I'm going to just discard two tiles and draw a card. And then we'll move on to the other phase. So, you're up.
Construction?
Mm-hmm.
This might be the one I needed. Potentially. Nope, it's the wrong direction. See, I need this, but I need it the other way.
Hmm.
Like that. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It makes it so difficult. Well, I don't want that.
I need to draw some cards here. So I'll draw one.
I'll draw the exact same tile twice.
Hmm. Well, that's interesting.
Is it?
Yeah.
Why?
I just want to see something here. I want to measure some stuff up.
Mm.
Ugh.
Right? you captured my sentiment beautifully.
Yeah, this is terrible.
I know.
I'm going to just place this one here.
So since these are exactly the same, I'll just stack them on top of each other.
For one. So that creates another link. So that's going to get me a card.
Where? Boop. Oh, okay.
Yeah. A receiving link. Yes. So that's one, two, and I draw one for three.
Okay.
All right. You done?
I placed, yeah.
Okay.
So
now we're in trucking.
Yes, and you are a player for one.
What?
You're up first.
I am a player one.
You are a player one.
So let me just check something out here. If that goes up to here, I can't load. But if it goes up to here, I can't load. This is really tough, just trying to figure out. Yeah, so I'll bring in the four truck. This guy. Size 4. 1 AP.
Okay.
So I will find him in this stack of goods. That's this guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to go bump. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So they stay on the board.
Yep.
And he will not load blue. Because it's right next to blue, but he will load red.
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
Which is good.
Mm-hmm.
So that's 1 AP. I could play 1 more AP worth of trucks if I wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah?
Sure. Go for it.
Little baby truck.
Oh, baby truck.
This guy.
Maybe I'll bump something into my... Yay! Boom. I can actually get something right, this time.
This guy is gone.
Okay.
This guy is going to push all the way up.
Wait. Why?
Because he's going to be gone too.
What?
Because he was hanging between boards.
Oh, he was?
So he's gone. Yeah, they can't hang off the board.
I have another secret factory over here, actually, that you don't know about. That's where I'm sending all of these.
Well, that's
people.
Good. So this is actually going to load blue and fill that truck. Which is going to earn me another tile. Ooh. I'll put that. Put that there. Well, that's pretty cool.
Are you done your truck?
Yeah, those are my two trucks. Done. Back to the regular phase. My goodness. I need to get some of your stuff here so I can start receiving. I need to be on the receiving end.
Well, I'm not on the shipping end of anything, so good luck with that. Yeah, I have no trucks, so I don't know if I should just sacrifice these. I have absolutely zero plan for what's happening in this disaster. So it's like I can't even use the truck if I exchange these right now anyway, so.
Okay. So
what are you doing?
Oh, what are we? Are we in?
No, this is my trucking phase.
Oh, you're still going.
I have not decided whether I'm going to take a card or not.
Oh, okay.
So,
sorry.
I know we blew through it last turn, but I'm actually thinking about taking a truck card this time.
Okay.
As my turn.
Fair enough.
So, I will do that. I have two. Look at this. I drew two of the exact same tile.
Oh, I could have used either one of those.
Well, nobody's using them now. They're going out of the game.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I could have scaffolded, I guess, with them. Ugh. I'm just gonna trash these, I guess. For one card. Okay. Now you can go and do your pipe building if you want.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just gonna place one here. And then draw one. These are bad.
I drew the same tile again. Are you kidding me? Oh, it's backwards. It's like the backwards version of that tile. Still not helpful at all. One. Nope. I'm just making a lot of like sort of connections. Three, rather. Alright.
Good?
Yeah.
Alright, trucking phase.
Okay. You're...
Oh, well, it's trucking, right? So, I'm gonna go ahead and discard these two, actually. And get a card. It's my action.
Whoops. I'm just gonna discard both of these.
Get yourself a card?
Yep.
Alright. I'm gonna need to draw some tiles here. Not liking what's happening.
Yeah.
In this construction phase.
I'm gonna get fired.
The same.
I'm putting my factory up for sale.
One. Two. Gosh, would you tile I can use, please? Ugh. Yeah, these are not good at all for me to use.
Oh, hallelujah. This is like the one tile I needed.
Ooh, there. Draw one more.
Yes.
Another link for you.
Yes. I get it.
The worst tiles.
Alright.
Now we're trucking.
Mm-hmm.
But you go first.
I'll go first.
You drew another truck, right?
I did.
Okay, good.
And I made a link, but I can't even.
You can't load that.
Well, it's not loading anyway. I would be receiving.
Oh yeah, that's right.
I'm just thinking.
Receiving's tough to line that up.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it's very tough.
That's why I only need to do it a couple times to end the game, right? You literally just need to receive four.
Yeah.
Four of either color and you end the game.
Right.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's no good. No bueno. 2, 3. There's like so many things that you have to like check. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I guess I could just start. I could just start bringing in trucks over here. 2, 3, 4, 5. No. I hate to send this guy out like not full here. You know?
Mm-hmm.
This guy? It's 1, 2, 3. He's not going to get anything. I have a 3, a 5, and a 6. You know?
A 6 will push him off your board.
5.
5 will push 6. Him off your board.
Yeah, because once he's off, he goes off completely,
right? He goes right to me, yeah. If he's...
Which means he's never going to... A big old truck's never going to fill up all the way down here.
Nope.
I could send him with a 3.
Yes, he'll stay on.
But 1, 2, 3 doesn't connect to anything.
Right.
And I don't, there is no one truck, so that's like, I can't use that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'm in the same position. So, like, I can't use any of these trucks over there mm-hmm. to benefit me at all. Which means I guess I'm moving your trucks.
Okay.
But I don't want to because they're nice and open, and you're going to deliver so much stuff. I don't feel like it. All right, I'm just going to use this and get more pipes. I'll just keep making.
Just keep getting pipes?
Yeah.
All right, so you're using that.
Go ahead.
Oh, okay, cool. I'm going to... Yes, I'm going to use this size 3 truck, which happens to be right here on the top of the pile.
Mm-hmm.
To push my little trucks up to there, because that'll bring blue into him, fill him up, and I get to draw a card. Well, tile. Right here. Boom. All right. My trucking is over.
Legally, all right, stacked, right? All right, so we can place, right?
Yeah, so now we're in the construction phase, so that's cool.
So there's that.
Put one here. So I'm going to put this on top of this tile. So what I've done is maintain the link, but it's now going to the 5th bay.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 1. I'll draw 1.
To the salt bay.
The salt bay. Drew this. Terrible tile. Yeah, I don't like that one. haven't been really drawing anything good for myself, unfortunately. So that works, that works. That works. I need to get something down that way. All right, maybe we can start trying to get some stuff going that way. Two, three. All right.
Did you just place everything?
Yep.
I don't think I did anything.
I placed two and I drew one, is what I did.
I didn't do anything yet. I'm so frustrated. It's just so hard for me to, like, visualize, like, what's going on. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. It's definitely a lot to think about.
It's just a lot to, like, visualize. You know what I mean? So I can do that. Two. But that's not going to work. Okay, I can do this anyway. I'll do one, right? Two.
You built into the link, huh?
Yeah.
You get one of these.
To get two, yeah.
That's good.
And three, I'll draw one. It's good, except if I keep pushing that thing, I haven't delivered anything. You know?
Are we in trucking now?
We are in trucking.
You go first.
Why do I draw these enormous trucks? Like, it's not even cool.
I don't know.
Yikes. One, two, three, four, six. It's gonna get pushed. It's like I can't really put any of these, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Down there either, because I'm gonna end up pushing this opportunity right off of my board.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And I could move that truck off, but it's like not really gonna help.
Unless you can load a new truck with some stuff.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to look at, but I really can't. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. That's like where his... Like, if I put my... I could do my six... Maybe this six truck.
Mm-hmm.
One, two, five, six. I could push him on there and load him up. With another blue, I guess. Not with this one. Because he's got some cargo in the front. I don't know. I guess I could do that. And...
Is that the one?
No, he's a six.
Oh, the big dog.
He's this guy.
Oh, man, that's a big truck.
I know. Yeah, tell me about it. I'm
right,
like...
So he's going to travel all
like
the way
the
off
gas station
the
here.
Board.
Yeah, he's coming all the way off. So he can go here.
All right.
And I can load a blue.
Okay. That's cool.
There. That's something.
And at the same time, this...
Yeah, of course.
Unloads into my.
So I have been not doing that.
Oh, all right.
But whatever. Well, I appreciate your support.
But thank you.
Having me put that truck out.
You know what? Your goods are finally going somewhere and
that
coming into
me
my.
That doesn't make me feel better.
Oh. Hey, look! I had a place just for it, so now we're good. That was your trucking move?
It was.
Your trucking move.
My trucking move.
All right, so I'm gonna play a truck as well. I'm going to need this size 4 truck right here somewhere. That's this guy. All right, so him, he's gonna push this guy off the board.
Mm-hmm.
Because these guys are all moving up, but this guy's gonna go here. These guys are gonna go like that. He's gonna get a red. Boom, fills him up.
Mm-hmm.
I get one of these. Put that there. Yikes. Oh, I get a blue truck token. That's cool. That's cool. Yeah, I'm done. That's all I get to do.
Got a lot of pipes, going to lots of different places. No plan. Zero plan.
You're in the... We're in the placement now?
We're in the placing phase now.
All right, so let's see about building some stuff. So that's one.
One. Oh, see, I don't... I guess I'll do that anyway. I'll just get the pick. So that's one.
I'll draw one.
Two. Of course.
Draw one for two. Ooh, what is this? Not what I want, but...
Just like you're staring at this tile.
Oh, I know. I'll draw one more.
Great.
See if we want this one. Three. It's not a bad one, actually. That's actually a good one. Just let me place a tile if I use this token again. Maybe play one token. I would receive an additional two actions to either place a splitter they own or to place a splitter. All right, so I can get two actions with this guy. So I'm going to do that. Mm-hmm. I'm going to place this one. I'm going to use one of my scaffolds, show how that works.
Okay.
I'll put that in the corner here.
You haven't used one already?
Nope.
I thought you did.
And do that.
Okay.
And that actually creates a link.
Nice.
A linkable.
A linkable.
And I will get a card for that. Whoa. That's just what I wanted.
Is it?
Is it? Not really. But it'll do, I guess. All right.
Okay, so let's see here. Which we got? What is this?
I actually get one more action.
What do you mean?
Because it gives me two actions, and one of them I placed a tile. I do have another action.
Well, please take your action.
Please take your action.
Please take your action.
Maybe I'll go like this. And get one of these. Are we in trucking now?
Yeah.
Mm.
I'm just trying to think of what this is going to look like if all that stuff gets pushed. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Because if all of this gets pushed by, like, six,
mm-hmm.
right? It's like, it's not like this guy goes and picks up a bunch of stuff. Like, it all goes... Right?
And where they stop.
And where it stops, that's where it loads. So you're correct. Trying to figure out, like, all right, this guy's going to end up off the board, right?
No, he's not.
Because all... If you put a 6 in here...
Nope.
That's pushing all this down.
That will push him to 7, 8, 9, 10, and the 6 will go to 1 to 6. Only these two trucks are going to go over. So that's 5. So they're going to take up to 5. So then this guy's going to go from 6 to 9.
Okay.
So you'll unload in 7. Which you don't have a pipe.
Yeah. Right. And then, like, these, where are these guys going to add up? Because I keep trying to, like, count.
I said, they're going to be from 1 to 5. So
yeah.
That'll be on 4.
Right.
And it's not the right color.
Right, that's what I looked at. Right. Okay.
This will be 1, 2, 3, which don't load.
Right.
So you would need to push them up a few times.
Yeah, this is not good. Mm-mm. 1, 2, 3, 5. So I have a 5 as well, but we're in the same position. Because mm-hmm. once he moves up, they can't straddle.
No.
So it's like, that's the hard part to kind of like
conceptualize. To conceptualize, right.
Because you're like, you think you can just add the numbers, but it doesn't actually work that way.
Correct.
So, okay. I'm just going to pass.
You're going to pass? Yeah. Okay.
I can't.
So... I don't know. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put some trucks out.
All
right. Let's see what happens here.
All
right. It's this guy. 5 trucks, so let's see what it ends up to.
So you're putting a 5 truck out?
Yep.
So this is...
5, so it's going to take all that up. These guys are going to go like that.
See, and that's where it's tricky. Right?
Yep.
Because like in my brain, I'm thinking, I mean, I knew this is why I didn't play my 5 truck,
mm-hmm.
but it's like, you think it'll be here
mm-hmm.
and I can pick up that blue,
but it's not
because he's got to come all the way over an extra spot.
Mm-hmm.
Oops. Oh, God.
That's all right.
He was here, right?
Yeah. But they're only one spot they could be on.
Okay.
All right. So that was my 5 truck brought in.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't load because he's full, but he gets a blue. And he gets a red.
Mm-hmm. Good job.
That's the game.
Oh, is it done?
I just delivered 10 goods, and
awesome.
nine goods is the
good job.
Gap.
Close forever.
Shut the factory down. Good Get the lights off.
I'm just...
Let's go talk about it. All right. I'm curious about that cargo.
Are you?
No.
I'm not.
I know exactly where it went.
I know exactly where it came from.
I almost cleared the shelves, man.
You did. You were just like, I just have all the cargo.
I'm ready to go home for the day.
I know. My guys were in there just like, I'm so confused. What do you want me to do? They were just building pipes.
That's it. They were just laying pipe. They should have just connected. You should have just connected your receiving machines to your shipping machines. Just had a circular
usually shipping. Well, actually, like the last time we played this, I actually did end up with one pipe.
That was a big circle.
And I thought it was going out. Okay. Let's talk about this because we have a shared experience, but we both have
Differing opinions about this game, which
is a little bit rare.
But I think it's good. I think it's good because it shows that, you know, there's certain things that click better with you and certain things that mechanics that click better with me.
So let's start with, I actually want to start with expectations for this one.
Mm-hmm.
Only because there were a couple of things that set my expectations. I won't say high, but just like set them,
mm-hmm.
just in a sense. One, you know, it came from Capstone, so mm-hmm. they've just been like hitting the nail on the head lately. So I was super excited. Second, I really enjoyed Pipeline. So I was expecting, without learning too much about the game, for mm-hmm. this to be a 2-player, like, faster playing version of Pipeline.
Mm.
That was my expectation going in.
Yes.
I don't know what your expectation was.
Not that.
But.
No, I mean, honestly, I kind of thought that, because that's what you just assume.
Exactly. Right? Like, because again, just base assumptions. When you
the
first
pipes look like the pipeline tiles, so it's only expected that you would think that there's similar mechanics mm-hmm. there, but there just aren't, right?
Right.
It's, you have the act of laying tiles down with the same tile placement rules.
Mm-hmm.
But that's...
That's where it ends. I play this like I play Pipeline, mm-hmm. and I just try to make like really long.
Like, I guess she's trying to get bonus points for the length of the pipe.
I am, which you don't get
because
bonus points.
It's not upgrading these red goods into purple goods depending on how many pipes you put in there. No, this game is about speed.
Yes,
and then anticipating where your opponent's going to load. if you want to capture the unloads. And also building up, you have to either really go hard pressed to ship or to receive, right?
Right.
And if your opponent is shipping.
Right.
And the trick is, and I've learned this after a few plays, because the first play, I'll admit, it was very tough on my brain.
Yeah.
Because I'm just like, I got to worry about you shipping and try to coordinate that, but then I'm also trying to figure out how I can get my stuff shipped, and I'm like, this is just too much. But it actually isn't. And what I've learned is, on the receiving end, and because it's, you think it's mathy, but it's not, because I'm looking at your board and you're like, okay, so you're loading blue on the five chart,
right?
I just need to receive blue on the five chart
every
time, and no matter what truck goes there, it's probably going to land on the five, or I need to make it land on the five for me to receive that, especially if you're loading a big truck, a six, because as soon as that six reaches my board, it's going to be lined up from the one through six.
Right.
Meaning that the five where you loaded the blue is going to come right into my bay. So that's kind of the thought process I had. But since you weren't sending any more goods my way, I stopped building receiving pipes.
Right.
And just focused heavily on using both sets of my machines to create shipping.
Right. That's good.
And then just kept pumping trucks through my bays.
Right. And that was a good way to go. I just had no plan. I really just wanted to have something work.
Mm.
And every time I tried to make something work, you pushed another stupid truck
away. I was just pumping trucks.
And, you know, probably I should have just stopped doing anything on this side, I guess. But it's like, what I struggle with in this game is, like, to me, there is very little you can do to plan anything. Like, you can plan, like you were saying, but from a, and I know, like, people are not going to agree with me on this, but what I'm trying to say is, like, there's a lot of interaction in the way that this game plays, obviously, and that's intentional. But it's kind of, it's hard to say, all right, I'm going to push a truck here so that I can receive goods the right way. You know what I mean? Because you take one move and it screws everything up.
If
I don't pull the right tile, I can't build the right kind of pipe. You know what I mean?
Correct.
So and that is where the challenge lies in this game. And I do find that puzzly piece, while difficult or like frustrating, that is fun. You know, but I think the part that I struggle the most with, and this is just how my brain operates, is that I have a very hard time visualizing what things are going to look like. Like, I can be looking at a tile and think it's the right tile and go to put it down and it's backwards. So it's like I'm like dyslexic when I'm looking at stuff. I don't know. It like my just my spatial like understanding of this is I don't know, it's not my strong suit.
And this this is a tough one because there's no flipping a tile around to
well, and maybe that might be it too, because that's what I always try to do is like flip it to make it work, because that's in most tile placement games you can like flip to the other side and now you have the opposite version
and this
of that
one
tile.
Doesn't afford that,
this does,
which
not
I like I think, because that makes it harder.
It definitely does.
And I want it to be hard. I want it to be hunting for that piece, because it's kind of pushing you to press your luck a little bit and go back in that bag. And do I spend my turn destroying tiles? Do I spend my valuable truck card getting more tiles to try to get that last, you know, that last piece that you need to complete this chain? I like that. So I think for me, like, it's hit or miss with these types of tile placement games for me, just because certain ones I just don't really enjoy. And I'll be honest, like, I'm not a big fan of the Uwe Rosenberg ones.
Right.
I'll be honest. I'm just not.
Yeah.
I liked them the first time I played them, and then I'm like,
A little stale.
They're almost just too much, right? There's just too much to think about going into them for what it is, right?
Right.
And then we played, like, that other one with the cats.
Calico. Yeah.
And that one kind of was much more refreshing. We played this one, and although it's thinky in a way that, for me, is more rewarding than I need to cover up this rock.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
And I think that's a really good point, because I, like, even though, like, the Uwe games with the tile placement, I know that, like, because we had this conversation, I think, like last weekend or yeah. something. We were playing Calico.
Mm-hmm.
The rules can be like a little finicky, but I actually feel like that's more, it's like more relaxing
mm-hmm.
for me puzzle wise with a game like that. And it's much easier for me to conceptualize where I'm going to put stuff and how I'm going to plan it out. And I don't know why. It's weird.
Yeah.
Because it's almost like we're two different. Like our brains
work, you know. They, you know, we're two
surprise.
Different. We're two different people who think differently.
Well, shocker.
Yeah. Now that I know you think differently than me, I may have to block you.
Well, anyway, you could go ahead and try to play this one on your own. It was like I wasn't even here.
No.
But anyway, I digress. No, I think that that was the challenging bit for me. It was just the visualization.
Mm-hmm.
But it was kind of cool to see because it's refreshing that that a tile placement game can bring that kind of
You know, when I first played this, I'll admit, I thought it was almost too thinky,
mm-hmm.
and I'm like, I was just a little intimidated by what was going on here. But I think as you ease into it, mm-hmm. at least it just clicks. Like this time it really clicked for me.
Right,
and I was just like, oh, I know what I'm doing. Boom, boom, boom. And I had a plan and it just all fell into place. And I was just like, I looked down at my card and I'm like, oh man, my thing's almost empty already. This game's gonna be over.
Yeah.
And like one more turn.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, I probably could have ended it two turns ago if I would have just played my truck cards.
Yeah, probably.
And just pushed my trucks through and just ended it.
Which is weird because I think like we didn't even use like the splitters this time,
mm-hmm.
which these are really cool. You didn't use them, did you?
I'll tell you what though. No, I didn't. But the splitters, you know, you would think that, oh, I should use a splitter. They're rare. There's only four of them in the game.
I know.
And they are expensive. You gotta, like, I could have traded my two trucks in for one, but what would that have got me? It allows you to kind of split one machine two ways.
Yeah.
Multiple ways because it'll split the pipe.
And my thing, though, is like, and this was kind of my point. So, like, it's hard to plan. Like, I'm looking at my pipes, right? And I'm mm-hmm. like, man, I could really use a splitter, like, right there.
Mm-hmm.
But then I have to like do, you know, a whole bunch of turns. I have to like try and like trade these in, get a truck, do this thing just to get a splitter for a pipe that I may not even be able to get onto a truck. So it's like, is it worth doing that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, maybe if I have all the stuff and it's like a, like, oh wow, this is something I can do if I need to.
This is definitely a game where you being the long-term planner.
Yes, and that's exactly.
This is a game where you have to pivot.
You do. Yeah.
Every round, you have to be ready to pivot. Mm-hmm. And like there was, okay, I need to reroute this pipe that I had built to another bay.
Yeah.
Because I know that your truck's coming, and I need to make sure I have a red to take that in, or a red to load that out.
Mm-hmm.
So I was constantly pivoting and trying to get
the
right trucks up to get them loaded. And I just kept getting goods out, out.
Yeah.
Right? And as I was doing that, you're trying to finagle it to bring them in, and it wasn't lining up in time. Instead of pivoting to start getting goods out and then hope you may run into.
Yeah.
Because had you started pushing your trucks, that might have changed the way
it may have. And I think that like looking at it, I it was kind of like I was working on the same system that you were working on,
mm-hmm.
because you were exploiting this system, and I'm sitting here trying to like finagle my end, my end of your system, really, is what it was looking like. So,
but at the end of the day, I mean, had you nailed your end of the system early, you could have ended the game, because you only need to receive four goods. So you could, if you can match and leverage my shipping to take in four of my blue goods, game would have been
trying.
Over. Yeah, like that's, but that's the trick, right? You have to nail it four times.
And you got to get, again, you got to get the right stuff coming out of the right engines. And,
Yeah, and it's kind of like looking and seeing, okay, you're going to take it, like if my truck moves up, it's going to hit bay four, not five, and you're looking to receive five. You need to shift that pipe to four before my truck gets up there.
Right.
And you need to be able to look ahead.
Yeah.
And hope that you have the truck card that can push my trucks into that position.
Exactly. I just never.
Which is why when the round before you moved your truck up to my bays, I shifted my pipe to five.
Right. Yeah.
Knowing it was coming so I could receive it.
I've never made that connection before.
Mm. So,
I'm just trying to visualize.
But that's our thoughts on this. I like this one. I think there's.
I do want to talk though about like components and things like that too. So let's get away from like.
Okay, from impressions.
Bit, but,
yeah.
As far as the components go and everything, I like the art style, like the color scheme and all of that. It is very organized. I'll just go like real quick over my thoughts and you add what you think. This is like inherent with tile placement games. Slippery board syndrome is, and you saw it in the beginning of this playthrough, is a problem, especially with like these tiles that make no sense. Like you have to put them in one spot, and if you knock them or the cat jumps up and jumps on them or something, you do have to kind of watch out for that. I don't know how you get around that, but
I'm not sure you can.
I don't think you can. So you do have to kind of to deal with that, but. The rest of the components and stuff I think are really nice, and I like the art and everything.
Yeah, it's very good quality. It's like this linen coated cardboard, which is really sturdy. Even especially the tiles are really smooth. They're thick. They're really really nice finish, almost like a plasticky finish to them, which
it's it's like that.
Yeah, but it's like they're really sturdy and nice wooden player tokens for the player track. Really good. Even these little like goods that you don't know what they are, like this like they're all nice wooden, they're painted, so everything's good. Any production quality wise right on point with what you'd expect,
right?
It's got a nice small footprint on the table, as it should for a two-player game,
right?
The tiles are small enough that they don't, you know, it's not like you're placing huge tiles. They're definitely smaller than pipelines. So I think it's the right size for what it is. It's pretty, it's clean. Iconography is right on point. So for me, I think this is definitely a good package.
Yeah. Cool. I guess I'm foreseeing people asking us if we like this or like Pipeline better. So I'm just going to answer it now. For me personally, and again, you can't really compare the two. It's like it's apples and oranges. They're completely different games.
Yeah.
But since people are going to ask, for me, I prefer Pipeline because it is a heavier, and I'll say heavier gently because this is definitely thinky, and it's heavy in a different way. But I like the long-term planning.
That's a big
and
time
that sort of
strategic
like tile time. Placement, route building, almost engine building, crunchy kind of. Get out of my factory. I'm building a pipeline kind of thing. But this is a very different experience than that. So definitely don't go into it looking like, oh, it's a two-player.
Yeah, I like both games. But if I had to choose which one we're going to sit down and play, I would choose this.
Okay.
Just because I'm no good at Pipeline.
See?
And I like winning. So I want to play a game that I'm going to win.
Well, there you go.
And this is the one I will win at. Okay. So. All right.
Anything else?
No, I think it's good. I'm glad we finally got this to the table.
Yeah, me too.
And hopefully, you know, you got a good idea of what Curious Cargo has to offer, even though we can't tell you what the cargo is.
Because
we don't know.
Still.
All right. So, thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed the playthrough. If you're not subscribed...
please subscribe.
Please.
You should
push
do it.
That subscribe button. It's absolutely free.
Absolutely. Smash that bell.
Yeah, and you'll be notified of upcoming videos. That's how it works, right?
I think that's how it works.
That's how it works.
I think if you hit the bell, then the YouTube will tell you, like, we did some more
We did
stuff.
Some stuff. There's a new video posted. Like, all of our subscribers will know that this just posted, and they got to watch this. And if you want to, follow us on Instagram.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I think you did it.
Did I do good?
You did it right, yeah.
Okay. So, again, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
See ya.